Good day, fellow investors. Today we'll talk about one of the biggest investing mistakes investors make, from beginners to specialists to long-term investors, which is anchoring. I now have 174,000 people on YouTube. Thank you for that. Subscribe to make it even bigger. I really appreciate it. I have about 28,000 people subscribed to my free stock market investing course, and I have enough people on my stock market research platform, which is the premium part of what I do with my in-depth research. But all these people give me a lot of interaction and a lot of feedback and a lot of sensing about how people think about the stock market. And there is one common theme that really affects everybody, even me, when it comes to investing, and that's anchoring. And this is just an example of a comment, a normal comment on my research platform. Everybody is so interested about the stock price. What did Sven pay for it? Did the stock price go up or down? And the main problem I see when it comes to investing is really the focus on the stock prices, not on investments. So you anchor your decision making on what the stock price is doing, what it has done, and that's extremely dangerous because it's completely the opposite than what owning businesses is and investing. If we look at what anchoring is a heuristic revealed by behavioral finance that describes the subconscious use of irrelevant information, past stock prices, such as the purchase price of security, as a fixed reference point or anchor for making subsequent decisions about that security. Let me give you a great example here. This is a company, let's say that I bought it here at 430 in August 1982. By November 1982, it was at 690, that's up 60%. So if I bought in August at 430, you would say, oh, now it's expensive, let's wait for it to come back. Sven paid what he paid for, so let's not buy. And that's the cost of anchoring. Because let's say we invested 1,000 in August of 1982, now would be 1 million as Berkshire is 1,000 times up. If we invested 1,000 in November at 690, you would have 678,000. So yes, you would be down 300,000 from me, but still 10 times or 15 times better than the market. And that's the cost of anchoring, because the focus is wrong, not on the business, but on the stock price. So if there is something you have to correct when it comes to investing, is anchoring on stock prices. But stock prices are so entertaining. Everywhere you look, you hear only about stock prices, not businesses. And that's something that I'm trying to, let's say, just give a word of common sense out there in that world of stock price noise. And the reason for all the stock prices is not that you will make money by following stock prices up and down on your Robin Hood, blah, blah, blah. The key is that stock prices are a great business because they keep your attention, keep your focus, they keep you entertained, they keep you in action, they keep you trading, thus commissions, they keep you looking at stocks, that looking at what happened, why this going up, why this going down, advertisement it sold, links, watching YouTube videos, all this mumbo jumbo about stock prices is a great business. And even if you look at CNBC, when they interview Buffett, they constantly show stock prices, stock prices, stock prices, because this keeps your mind entertained, and that's the enormous danger of anchoring in stock prices. This is from 24 February 2020, just before the COVID crisis. Look at S&P 500 laggards while Warren Buffett is talking. Pause this, check the stock prices now, and look at what happened. Because those that focus on businesses, they understand the risks and reward of investing. But the media and everyone is always pumping these stock prices because it helps keeping you entertained. And if I would had stock prices that constantly go under my video or that, my viewership would be much higher. But that would be against the principles of long-term boring investment, or you can check more by watching my video, and I'll put it in the card here, about watching paint dry investing. Do good investing, boring as watching paint dry, and then go live life. Don't watch the tickers going up and down. That's insane. And then there is the positive and the negative. Some people look at the negative and they say, okay, the S&P 500 was lower, so it will crash, therefore I'm not buying, and it just keeps going up. And other people look, oh, this is just going up, up, and up, so that's good. Stocks go only up, up, and up, so it is a buy. But that's nothing to do with fundamentals. Similarly with Alibaba, a year ago, 6 months ago, 8 months ago, everything was positive, fast growth. It will be a great business, great stock. And then suddenly the market sentiment turned on Alibaba, and now it's still very, very negative. But it's extremely important how all the people are focused on the stock price and not on the underlying business. You have my Alibaba video that I will update soon, so subscribe and click that notification bell for that. But my main message is that try to think about owning businesses. And what does it mean to own businesses? Let's just check the S&P 500. Dividend yield is 1.something%. That's the expected return that you have to look forward, and you have to see whether that plus the growth there, inflation protection, is something for you. If you're happy with that, put your money. If the stock goes down, put more money. You're happy, you get something that you like already at a discount. If it goes up, compared to others like we did yesterday or the weekend with Berkshire. Be careful not to be obsessed about stock prices. Invest in businesses, be a business owner, and your life and investing and financial life will be much, much better. Thanks for watching, smash that like button, and I'll see you in the next video.